Hi guys, today let's discuss on why to set up a virtual box or a virtual environment rather than installing the same things on a dual boot OS. So what the problem is like while doing a dual boot operating system, if you don't know how to do the proper setup, then it will be a problem and then we need to face some problems. So in order to avoid this kind of things, what basically we can do is like we can go with a virtual box or a VMware, wherein we can set up any kind of operating system virtual machine. So on a Windows operating system, on a Windows host, we can set up the virtual box. In the virtual box, we can have any kind of operating system setup, like it can be of a Windows Server OS level, or it can be a Mac OS, or it can be a Linux operating system. So let's see how to set up VirtualBox first, and then followed by how to set up the operating systems and bring up the virtual machines on the VirtualBox. So our agenda, which we are going to cover up, like we are going to set up the virtual machine with different kinds of operating system flavors. It can be Windows, or it can be Linux, or it can be Mac. So what's the difference between the setup for these different operating systems on a virtual machine? Windows and Linux is almost the same, and for Mac OS, as prerequisites of some scripts need to be run before bringing up the virtual machine. So let's see how to set up the virtual machine first, and then how to boot from the Windows disk image file, or if you're having a readily available virtual disk image file, then it's rather good, or else we need to go with the disk image file, operating system disk image file, and then we need to do the installation as we do with our general host, like Windows installation or Linux installation, Mac installation. If we are having an already built up VDA file or a VDMK file, that is virtual disk image file, if it is already available, then we don't need the operating system installation to be done. Everything is ready and we can just utilize it. So let's see how to set up the virtual machine. First, let's understand the basic differences between iOS and VDA or VDMK files. Let's get into understand these things. Let's see the difference between these two things. So ISO image file format is like the bootable format of the OS, which we will be embedding it into optical drive or an hard disk or a live boot. So when we are trying to boot on a general system, we are going to take up the USB pen drive, and then we are going to load up the ISO bootable image file, and then we are going to kickstart the booting process and the installation process from there. So it's the general thing. It is common in a general host system, or maybe it is in a virtual machine. If you are having an image file, iOS image file, then we need to start with the installation of the operating system and all things. So it basically starts from installation of the operating system. So if you are having a VDA file rather than an iOS image file of the operating system or the operating system flavor, so if you are having a Windows 10 VDA file, virtual disk image file, so it is like everything is installed and pre-built into it. You just need to plug in and then you can start working on it. So it's already an available machine with you, and you just plug in and you will be working on that. If it is an iOS image format, we need to start installing, we need to plug in the iOS flavor, OS flavor, that can be a Windows or Linux or a Mac, and then we need to start the general installation. It takes up hours of time. And then once it is done, and once you run start up the machine, virtual machine, then you will be ultimately getting the VDA file. From the next time onwards, you can directly use the VDA file instead of starting it from the beginning. So you can distribute that VDI file to anyone, and they can utilize directly that already existing machine. They can use it. They will not be facing that installation and all those things again. So to understand it in a better manner, let's come up with an analogy. Like you can see an analogy for better understanding. So if it is an ISO image format of the flavor, Windows flavor or Linux flavor you are having with you, then what happens? It is like an assembled PC where you need to start building from the base, installing all the OS and then installing all the related software and all those things. But when you come up with a VDI file or VDMK file, the VirtualBox image file or the VMware virtual image file, when these kind of files are available readily with you, with a Windows operating system or with a Linux operating system or Mac operating system, it's like a branded PC which is available with you, which has already inbuilt operating system in it, and you can just start working on it. So that's the basic difference between the file formats. So it's basically, it depends upon which file format you're having. So if you're having a VDI file, you will not be having the installation process and all those things. Yes, you will start the operating system, like how you start your host machine, and you can run it. So what are the prerequisites? So prerequisites is like, if you're having an image file, ISO image file, then you need to start with the installation and all those things. So when you start the virtual machine, the installation process begins. So it takes hour or something based on the kind of operating system flavor which you are having. And then once it ends up, you can start utilizing the machine. If it is a VDI image file, virtual disk image file, then we can just run the machine, plug in the virtual disk image file, and then you can just start the machine, and you can utilize it. There is no installation process as such. And then the VirtualBox installer, it can be a VirtualBox that is coming free of cost from Oracle or the VMware machine. We can utilize any of those. And then the next one is the hardware requirements. When you're setting up a virtual machine, your hardware requirements should be based on the operating system flavors. If you are going to Mac machine, then a minimum of 4 GB should be there for the virtual machine for it to run properly, and then 4 GB for your host machine. So in total, a minimum of 8 GB should be available. Only then it comes up properly. So now let's see the virtual machine installation and setup process. So first we need to download the VirtualBox installers. Whether it is an VMware, then you need to go to the VMware site and you need to download the VMware setup box, VirtualBox, or you need to go and get it from, if it is VirtualBox if you are trying to utilize, then you can go and get from the Oracle's VirtualBox. So you can see different packages are available for different host machines. If it is for Mac machine, a different VirtualBox file, different installer is available. If it's for Linux distribution, different installer, Windows host, then it is a different installer is available. So mine is a Windows host, so my machine basically is a Windows machine, so I need to go with the Windows host. So these are the these are the builds that are stable. So let's go with the stable builds. So you can see in here, it says the same thing, Windows host. So mine is a Windows host, so I need to download this installer. So I already have the installer downloaded, so I'm skipping this process. And then it's self-explanatory. It is just how to set up this VirtualBox is just next process. It's nothing. Whatever it has, just click on next, and it will get completed. So let me show you how to start it. here is my VirtualBox downloaded. It's from Oracle, free of cost. So you can just click, double click on it. And the installation process begins. Just click on next, next, next. So I already installed, so it shows up repair and remove. So it shows installation for you. Just click next, 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 and the installation will be completed. And if it asks for support tools, you can just click on OK and continue, and the support related tools will also get installed. So once it is installed, you will be having a kind of shortcut like this, Oracle VMware, VM VirtualBox, Virtual Machine VirtualBox. So double click on it to start, and you will not be having any of these kind of virtual machines available. It will be completely empty. So this is what you will be having. Suppose this. So once the installation is installation of the virtual box is completed, then we need to set up the virtual machine. So how do we start up setting up the virtual machine? So follow me. So click on new. So it says like create new virtual machine and give the name of the virtual machine. Assume like I am installing Windows flavor of virtual machine. So I'll give Windows name. Any name that is feasible for you to understand the type of operating system, you can give it over here. And then you can select the Windows operating system version, Windows 7 or 10 or 2012 server if you're installing anything. So assume like it is a 2012 server and click on next. And then do the space. So the RAM, how much amount of RAM is a prerequisite from that particular operating system. For that particular operating system, we need to provide that amount of RAM. So in case of Windows 12 operating system, assume like I'm doing 2 GB, and then click on next and say you are going to create a new virtual hard disk now. So click on create now. And then what we wanted is like once the OS, we wanted to create a VDI image file. Since we are not having a VDI image file, we are going to choose the VDI image file. So you can see here, please choose the type of the file that you would like to use. The new virtual hard disk, for the new virtual hard disk. If you do not need to use it with other virtualization software, you can leave the setting unchanged. Okay, and then click on next. So if you're going with virtual machine of VMware, then you can select a VMDK file. Or if you're going with the Oracle VirtualBox, you need to go with VDI file. And then leave it like this, dynamically allocated. Based on the type of operating system and everything, it gets, the size gets varied. And then whatever the amount of size you want it to give. This is not fixed as we are given dynamically varying, so it varies after this. So assume like I'm giving 50 GB, or assume like I'll be giving 10 GB or something. So 10 GB I'm giving. And then where the VDI file needs to get created, so choose the path. Assume this is the path where my VDI file needs to get installed, created. So give the name as we are given Windows operating system. So the VDI file gets created with windows.vdi file. So click on save and create. Once it is done, you can see the virtual machine is created with Windows name as Windows, and click on settings, right click and click on settings, or directly choose this one, select this one and go to settings. And from here, you can change the settings you have made it. So this can be done only when you are not running the virtual machine. If you wanted to change any of these settings, then you need to stop the virtual machine, and then again you can change the settings, modify it, click on OK, and then start the virtual machine. So come to storage and then click on empty and remove it. If you are having directly the VDI file, then you can plug in the VDI file. Else, what we need to do is like now assume like I'm having a image file, iOS image file of Windows, or assume like I'm having it with Linux. So what I'll be doing is next, I'll be deleting this one. And I need to give the source from where I'll be taking that file. So it was located on my hard disk. So I'll add the CSA controller. And then go add, choose it from the existing disk. It was on my disk local disk. So in my storage, may add the CSA controller and then choose the operating system. Okay, in here. So assume the disk image file of iOS disk image file of Ubuntu machine. Assume this is the Windows iOS file I'm having. Since I'm not having the Windows image file, I'm just showing up with the Ubuntu machine. So this is the Linux machine iOS image file I'm having. Just click open. Click OK. So now since I'm not having the disk image file, virtual disk image file, that is the already existing pre-built operating system that is not available with me, I'm having only the bootable OS. So I need to do like this. So once I click on start, what happens is it starts with the installation process of Linux operating system. So you can see the next installation process will begin. So let me skip up with this process and let me show you if you are having already a VDI file available, then how to plug in with the virtual disk image file directly.